I knew all along that you would be the one. I knew that you would wake me.
点的是熏鲑鱼，然后有水煮蛋、洋葱、番茄，还有贝果。是我妈点的。你点什么？蛋、培根。哦，她点 American breakfast， 看起来很好吃。然后还有
sausage and。
大家早安，我现在只露一个眼睛了，因为现在外面是一度，是不是？
零下一度。
对啊，零下一度吗？
嗯哼。
哦，你看。看得到有烟吗？我们现在要走去那个国会大厦，理论上它是可以先预约 tour 的，但是我们就我啦，我本人忘记先预约，我的眉头是不是画太深？所以我们今天就没有 tour 可以走，我们就自己看看吧。后面的那个景色很漂亮，我们今天打算去完国会大厦之后呢，会去那个航太博物馆。我们去完之后就。沿着那个我不知道叫什么白宫草坪吗还是什么，就一路往西那边，一路上都有各式各样的景点跟纪念碑可以看。没错，今天的计划就是这样。到国会了，大家知道来国会大厦不能带说任何吃的或是液体吗？我们今天要走一整天的路，可能带了一堆吃的，就现在全部要丢掉。然后我妈刚刚她居然说她想要捍卫这包零食，所以她不进去。然后我就说怎么可能？现在站在门口要把这么多零食，其实里面还有，要把它全部吃完再进去。她刚吃过老汤了，看要吃那个饼干。
天气冷嘛，需要热量。
I love small talks and cute things, but most of all, I love your eyes. I may not show it, I'm really cool, but you're the one I secretly added. Wash your silver ribs, oh.国际航太博物馆。它的肉很咸，虽然蛮好吃的。我们刚刚吃完了那个 burrito。啊，我们现在在这个草坪上，后面这边是华盛顿纪念碑，然后被餐车挡住了。这里是国会大厦，现在太阳要下山了，这一圈超漂亮的，给你们看。白宫，这边是国家二战纪念碑。
noticed you blushing, you noticed me too, and I can't help but feel like I'm falling for you.
Ping, Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania.
对。
P-E-N-S
错
P-E-N-S-U-N
P-E-N 然后嘞
P-E-N-S-U-V-I
S-Y-L
B-A-N-I A
对
I noticed you blushing You noticed me too And I can't help but feel it
哇又后面
I noticed you blushing You noticed me too And I can't help but feel it
我们现在在华盛顿的 Sounding Farmers 吃晚餐。其实我原本朋友是推荐我吃早午餐，可是因为呢，考虑到路线的规划，我们就跑来吃晚餐。这家听说是就是华盛顿这边很有名的一家餐厅，然后我看网络上超多人在推荐，什么要分数很高，小红书上面也很多人推荐，希望等一下会好吃。我们点的是今日例汤，这个是 Chicken Noodle Soup。早餐。我们现在来到间谍博物馆。
As an intelligence collector.
Hello， 大家好，现在是晚上5:30，然后我们刚刚2:30的时候从华盛顿坐，那叫什么客运吗？算客运吗？客运差不多坐3个小时就可以到达费城，然后呢，我们现在已经进到饭店里面了，给你们看一下，我们住在那个中国城附近，噔噔噔，这是浴室，噔，也是有一个全身镜，这呢是床。等一下休息一下，我们要去吃晚餐了。看起来还不错啊。Hello， 我们吃完晚吃完早餐，我们吃完早餐，然后我们现在要去一个叫做什么 Philadelphia's Magic Garden， 那因为走路大概16分钟就可以到了，所以我们现在打算走路过去。现在早上11点，走过去大概快11:30。 了。刚刚门口工作人员说，这个是一个艺术家从1991年开始装饰到现在，然后到现在这边都还是有在增加，地板也很可爱。太阳洒下来的时候会这样亮亮的，很漂亮。
So the hood was so that they wouldn't recognize anybody on their way back to their cell, and that they wouldn't be recognized. It avoided them having an understanding of the topography and the way around the prison, so that wasn't attached to the building anymore. So a lot of changes had to occur from the way this place was supervised, the whole. So this is the picture I showed you guys a little bit earlier. Anybody remember who painted it? Yeah, I didn't.
这里可以进去。就是这应该是马桶吧？
对啊。
The youngest person over here is the youngest. How old are you?
17.
Yeah, you're too old. Is anybody here younger than 17? How old are you?
14.
All right. The youngest person here was 11.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, she was a girl named Mary Ash. She was here for arson. She was African American, and at that point in time, from what I've read, arson was a very popular, I guess, for lack of a better term, charge for young African American women, especially those who were homeless. So I think it was this like umbrella of...a charge that they could just go up to somebody and say, I'm going to charge you with arson. If they found them homeless on the street, they would bring them into jail. She was charged, she was supposed to spend 4 years here. She only spent 2, and then she passed away from tuberculosis, unfortunately. There was a young man, too, who was also 11, that was also here for arson. So, it's interesting to hear, like, arson and vagrancy were two very...kind of popular charges at the time, because vagrancy especially could be used in any number of cases. So let's say that you were a 22-year-old woman and you were out with some friends having a drink or two at the local pub and you were walking home, you could be arrested for vagrancy, especially if you were unkept. That was if you weren't walking home with a husband or a man orIt was definitely a way of creating classism here in Pennsylvania. So it's sad that happened, but that was definitely what was going on. Any questions?
其实这监狱真的很大哎、欸，哇，那它透光。这边有一个 double bunk.
People try to feel badly for what they had done. So this penitentiary was a way to get away from that. In the corner is where the only successful escape happened. So there was a guy by the name of Leo Callahan, and Leo and four of his friends got together and decided that they would create this system of ladders that when unsnapped or when they weren't put together, they resembled a piece of furniture that would be in a jail cell. So they were able to smuggle in three revolvers, don't ask me how. And they overtook a guard that was working down in the corner down there. Now this is before the guard shacks were on top of the tower. Prior to that, they were on the ground. So they overtook this guard, tied him up, put him in the guard shack, and then they unsnapped the ladder, put it together, put it on top of the guard shack, and it actually went over the wall. They were able to scale down the other side using like a hook and rope system that they, it always, I picture Batman always comes up in my head when I talk about this. I always picture him like scaling down the other side, you know? So Leo has never been found, he's still at large. Now, that was 1923, I'm sure they has probably passed away by now, but he's never been found. One of his friends made it all the way to Hawaii before he was found, but the other two were picked up relatively quickly. But I always find it interesting, and maybe you guys might agree with me, when you hear about stories of people escaping jail or watch movies about escapes, do you always find that you're rooting for the guy that's escaping? Isn't that interesting? So anyway, that happened in 1923, and because of that, the warden got fired. The new warden came in and fired 90 of the 120 security guards who worked here at the time. The guard towers were built and put in place, and so it was a really bad time. There were four inmates here called the Four Horsemen that were basically running the prison at the time, so there was drugs all over the prison, there was all kinds of stuff going on that shouldn't have been going on, so that had to come to an end. So there was a huge controversy in 1923. They needed a piece of good news. You were asking about some of the famous inmates. So that's when one of the more famous inmates was booked in, and I'll show you his picture if I can find it. That's when this guy was booked in. All right. So this is Pep. So this is Pep the dog. He was booked in. He was actually booked in. This is his actual mugshot. And he was booked in for supposedly killing the governor's cat. Now it's still questionable whether that happened or not. The governor's wife says it didn't happen, but he was booked in here. I think the real story is that they needed some good news after such a really bad year, that they brought Pep in, created this kind of feel-good news story. He had the run of the grounds, and from what I understand, he was kind of like the first therapy dog that existed. But he did spend 3 years here, and then after his third year here, he was transferred to Greaterford Prison. Do you guys all know where that is? It's about 20 minutes north of here. But he spent the last 4 years of his life there and then passed away, and they gave him a nice burial out there and a really nice grave and everything. But he was here in just after 1923 to try to get some better news about the prison circulating. Stairs are really steep and the ceiling's really low, so please be careful.
Punishment cell.
This is a
我们看完这个东周教养所了，然后它这个其实是
2017，反正就是快200年的历史。他刚刚说，因为这个监狱是一个放射状的，它有点像是马车的车轮，然后你把它推倒之后，它就会成一个中间有个中心，然后往外发射。所以它总共有一开始是有8个牢房的区域。然后后来就因为人口暴增，囚犯的人数就上涨，所以他们就后来又盖了很多不同的监狱。但是因为当这个人数上涨，他的在控管上面就会出现漏洞跟一些一开始没有预期到的事情嘛，所以后来差不多1970年应该那时候这个监狱就关掉了。这个一开始是设计是想要做一个更人性化，就那时候有很多人在思考说这个犯罪改革的事情，就是怎么样让监狱可以做得更好之类的。这边呢，他一开始是主张说，你让囚犯他们都是单独的监禁，是一个比较好、比较人道的选择。所以一开始他们都是让他们一人一个牢房，然后一整天24小时自己吃饭、自己玩乐、自己工作。但是到后来，因为人太多了，而且这其实会造成很多的心理疾病，所以后来呢，我猜他们应该就也有改革了吧。对，总之呢，这监狱我觉得如果你不会特别害怕或是排斥的话，可以来看，因为它里面开放的东西很多。然后我们参加的是它每天都会在早上10点半跟下午2点有一个 tour， 然后就会有一个 tour guide 带你就是大概看几个点，然后跟你说故事这样。但是你也可以来这边，它都会提供那个语音导览，那语音导览的内容就更丰富，你就可以自己走。然后这里面真的很多都可以让你看，然后也有探讨很多就是监狱的问题。而且我记得它的门票是一个人14块，然后学生的话是10块钱，就真的不贵。然后我真的建议，如果大家不排斥这种东西的话，可以来看一看，然后了解这座很古老的监狱的历史。Terminal Market 就是在车站旁边的一个有点像是美食广场的地方，然后我们来吃晚餐。对啊，这应该是上面是可以吃的饭堂。
要不要买一个试试看？
看起来很甜欸，我还宁愿吃这个。
这是那个肉桂的，这个还好，我好像有吃过。
Biscotti
这个应该还好。
Can I get a spoon?
Is that thing empty? I think we should get that.
Oh. Oh.我们回饭店呢，现在时间是6点，然后我们刚刚去那个 Reading Terminal Market， 其实因为我们去有点算是意外，今天早上为了要找早餐吃，所以就意外的踏进市场，里面有一些卖一些熟食，然后一些餐厅，但是也有很多是卖生鲜，然后卖水果的，总之就是一个像这样复合式的市集。我们买了2家，一个是叫做 Herschel's， 然后它是卖那种像有点像牛肉三明治，然后我在网上看他说是犹太人的食物，牛肉是削这样一片一片，对，这样像削这样一片一片的，等一下来吃吃看它好不好吃。然后另外呢，买的是这一家叫做 By George， 它有卖披萨。意大利面跟一些热的千层面啊、肉啊什么，就是比较意大利式的料理。那我们买了2个，这都是冷面沙拉。对，这个是长这样子，然后这个呢也是长这样子。对，它这个是就是称重量卖的，想说就可以买2个来试试看。然后我们还买了一个那个水果草莓，这个一个才2块钱，好便宜哦。我在纽奥良买这个一个都4块钱呢，这样差不多这样的分量要4块钱。我们现在来吃吃看，你要热是不是？嗯。好，那我来帮你热。啊？他有在弄吗？看起来还可以吧，还行吧，闻起来还蛮香的。好，谢谢。还有优格。今天吃饭店的早餐。 大家早安，今天是平安夜的白天，
这还算平安夜吗？
平安白天，然后呢？我们现在要走去那个费城的美国独立纪念馆，还有自由州，它刚好就在我们饭店附近，所以走路大概20分钟就到了。然后去完这个之后呢，我们要去一个好像是费城最古老的街道，也是全美国数一数二古老街道吧，然后叫做 Alfred's Alley， 就在美国独立纪念馆的附近。我们等一下也是要走路去。今天我们下午5:30的时候，是5:30吧？5:30的时候呢，就要坐车坐客运去纽约平安夜。这个就是美国独立纪念馆，自由州应该是在这个里面。我们等一下也会去看。其实这不是他的正面，但因为背面太背光了，所以就决定来他的背面拍。它的正面有一个很大的裂痕，是这个钟标志性的象征。到了这个 Alfred's Alley， 就在这个里面。其实就是一个很窄的巷子，然后蛮短，一点点而已。你们看，我很喜欢他们家的花圈，因为它上面有这个羊毛毡的雪人，还有这个三个颜色的蝴蝶结，好可爱哟。午餐又是吃披萨，看起来还蛮好吃的。我们刚刚吃完午餐，然后现在走来我们饭店附近，因为我们饭店就住在 Chinatown 里面，然后有一家我在网络上看到有人推荐的抹茶千层蛋糕店，我们就来吃。我们到纽约了。 Hello， 我们到纽约了，然后我们这次是住 Newport， 这边就是 Jersey City，它在曼哈顿岛的西边，这是我们住的饭店，一个晚上才不到，应该不到4000块吧，但是这房间还蛮大的，来给你们看一下。这边呢就是浴室，然后这边有个镜子，为什么这个浴室长这样？好，然后这边走进来呢，哦，它的那个浴缸在这里，然后这边是衣橱，这边有个全身镜。然后呢，房间还蛮大的，这边有个床，然后可以面对外面的那个市景。这边有一个大的沙发，然后转过来面对这边就是很大的电视。这边还有一个很长的桌子，有很大的地方可以放东西，还蛮不错的。今天是平安夜，我们要做什么？请问，我们现在在饭店旁边的日本料理吃晚餐。给大家看一下这边的 view， 很漂亮。哇，看起来好好吃哦！你叫的是什么？天妇罗乌龙面吗？是吗？
对。
然后还有附这个豆皮寿司的小菜，这个是我点的。
I can't help.